When Simon Brown met young Tempe, he didn't know what to expect. He knew his disfigured face was not a pretty sight, and it often caused children to have unpredictable reactions. But as soon as the little girl started talking, Simon knew that this time was different, and she impacted him more than she could ever realize. Hello, story lovers. I'm Jamie Buck, and here is... Disfigured veteran with scars says hi to five-year-old. Her response brings millions to tears. Before we move on, make sure you smash the like button, subscribe to our channel, and activate the notifications bell for new amazing videos. Simon is a former British Armed Forces member, having served as a Royal Engineer for 13 years. His 7-month deployment in Iraq came to an abrupt end in December 2006 when a transport carrying 6 of his colleagues broke down and was attacked. Simon came to their aid and successfully rescued them. But as he was leaving the area, he was nearly killed. He had been shot by a sniper rifle. The bullet entered Simon's left cheek and exited through the right one. The impact destroyed both his cheek bones, shattered his left eye, and severely maimed his right one. "Thank God I didn't pass out," he remembers. "My palate had collapsed and I couldn't breathe. I put my thumb in my mouth to hold it up and keep my airway open." He was in danger of suffocating. Simon was taken to nearby Basra Palace for an emergency tracheotomy. When he was airlifted to his base, where he underwent surgery, he was put into an induced coma. The next day, he was flown back to Britain. He would need many more operations to rebuild his face and was now functionally blind. His life had been turned upside down, and he didn't know how to cope with his new reality. He spent a lot of time at Selly Oak Hospital, where he received treatment and rehabilitation. Simon's nose and cheekbones were reconstructed using titanium. His jaw was completely remolded, and he was fitted with a prosthetic eye. But he still had to learn to live as a blind man. Thankfully, he wasn't all on his own. Simon received support from Help for Heroes and Blind Veterans UK, two charities dedicated to helping injured veterans go back to a normal life. With their financial, practical, and emotional support, Simon was able to adjust his new situation and learn how to live independently. But maintaining his self-confidence is an everyday struggle. 11 years after his injury, Simon has undergone 25 operations to rebuild his face, but his scars and prosthetic eye are still quite visible. He knows he stands out when he's out in public. He tries not to let it get to him, but it isn't always easy, especially when he's around children because he's afraid to scare them. But that all changed when he met Tempe. Temperance Pattison, known as Tempe, is a 5-year-old girl from Darlington. When she was 3, she asked her mom, Emily, why people were wearing red poppies. Her mother told her about the Poppy Appeal, the Royal British Legion's fundraising effort to help veterans reintegrate to civilian life. Tempe immediately knew she wanted to help, and she did so in the most amazing way. It was the concept that someone would put her life at risk to keep her safe, when they hadn't even met her, explains Emily. Tempe swam a 100-meter race, raising 53 pounds for Help for Heroes. The next year, she undertook a mini triathlon and raised 450 pounds. When the charity told her about the new campaign, Facing It Together, it was an opportunity to finally meet a veteran. Help for Heroes planned a video shoot where Tempe would get to meet an injured veteran to have a short conversation. They chose Simon, who was one of the first soldiers helped by the charity. Simon didn't know what to expect when they told him he'd be sitting right across from a 5-year-old girl. But as they both sat down and started talking, he knew this was an experience like no other. Tempe started by introducing herself. Her manner was confident, and she looked Simon straight in the eye. She was unfazed by his strange appearance. Feeling more at ease, Simon also introduced himself and told her how he became injured. "What was the thing you got shot by again?" asked Tempe. She didn't seem to mind the grisly details. Next, it was his turn to ask her a question. Simon asked Tempe why she swam 100 meters and raced in a triathlon. "Because even though I didn't know any soldiers, I just thought that they did something for us. I just thought I can give a present back to them by raising them money," she answered. "I am quite proud of the soldiers." Those words almost brought Simon to tears. The veteran told Tempe he and the rest of the soldiers were also proud of her. "I'm 38 and a half and I can't do a triathlon," he quipped. Tempe then went on to confess that she was afraid to ride her bike during the triathlon, but she still did it, using stabilizers. Simon knew that this was no ordinary little girl. "You like to challenge yourself, don't you?" he asked her. Yes, because the soldiers challenge themselves, she replied. Simon went on to thank her for what the challenges she takes on, noting the money she raises helps people like him rebuild their lives. So that's why people like you are our heroes, Tempe smiled, knowing exactly what to say. And people like you are mine, said the little girl. They fist bumped and the video ended. It was later posted on Help for Heroes' YouTube channel, but it wasn't until The Sun shared it on their website that it exploded. Within 2 days, it had racked up 25 million views. The public was smitten with Tempe and Simon, and they wanted to see more of the pair. Shortly after the video went viral, Simon, Tempe, and her mother appeared on ITV's This Morning. The show's host asked Tempe what she thought about when she first saw Simon. That he looked really brave, was her response. She also announced her next challenge would be a 5K race. I believe she'll continue fundraising for the rest of her life, said her mother. Did you like the story? Check out our channel for more.